Imagine a volcano which emits 20 tons of gold each year as a gas, which is then almost all precipitated into a gold-rich ore mineral. This might sound like science fiction, but what I just described actually occurred, albeit with a different element which is even rarer than gold. Not only is it rarer than gold, but it is one of the rarest stable aka non-radioactive elements in the Earth's crust. What I'm referring to is the element rhenium, aka element number 75 between tungsten and osmium on the periodic table, where an abundance of this incredibly rare element is produced each year via the mineral rhenite. This valuable mineral occurs in tight clusters of a silvery to black metallic mineral which is by weight 74.38% rhenium. Due to its rarity, it is somewhat valuable, meaning that each ounce of rhenite is, as of the making of this video, worth $33.74 in US dollars. However, do not go onto the Kudryavy volcano or its surrounding area to take minerals and or rocks, as that is not allowed, and it, in my opinion, appears that some entity already owns the mining rights on this volcano. The rhenite occurs in clusters of material adjacent to very hot fumaroles, some of which are consistently more than 300 degrees Celsius, with the mineral precipitating from fumarole gases at the volcano. However, chemists in my audience might note that rhenium has the second highest boiling point of any element, requiring more than 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit or 5,538 degrees Celsius to turn it into a gas. Yet, the lavas the Kudryavy volcano can produce are generally no more than 2,192 degrees Fahrenheit or 1,200 degrees Celsius. So, what exactly causes this element to boil away and turn into a gas? The answer is not some exceptionally hot layer deep in the Earth's mantle, but rather relates to the secondary element rhenite is bound with due to its chemical formula of RES2, sulfur. Generally speaking, when a mineral contains two elements at varying concentrations, the relevant melting and boiling points of that mineral are generally less than that of one of the elements it contains. The same thing applies for a hypothetical solid solution of a mineral with the elements rhenium and sulfur, which might look something like this. Thus, this hypothetical temperature falls within the known range of temperature fumaroles and magma/lava can produce, allowing for rhenium as an element to melt and become a gas. But why might there be so much rhenium as an element in the first place, since the deposit on the surface, in my opinion, represents remobilized rhenium from deeper in the crust? This aspect is uncertain, but I propose one possibility. At depth, there might be a massive sulfide deposit with a large molybdenum-rich ore body. This ore body, in turn, might be getting melted by volcanic gases, magma, or residual heat from both, which in turn releases minute concentrations of rhenium present in the ore into a concentrated gas, which then rises to the surface where it is deposited. I say this because rhenium as an element is traditionally mined as a very rare but present byproduct of some molybdenum ores. This is somewhat supported by the occurrence of molybdenum minerals in the same field of fumaroles. Despite the fact that this volcanic complex has a potential for explosive eruptions and last erupted in 1999, there is surprisingly an attempt to mine all this material, although I was unable to find many details on the exact specifications on how this would occur. Kudryavy is a soma volcano, that is, a stratovolcano which grew out of a large caldera. This caldera formed in a VEI-6 explosive volcanic eruption 410,000 years ago, which coated the landscape in 90 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock, forming a 10.7 kilometer long and 9 kilometer wide caldera. Through the next several hundred thousand years, four different volcanic cones grew along an east-northeast trending line. Occasional lava domes erupted, and viscous lava flows covered a section of the once vast caldera lake which existed. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.